Good day, my name is Emmanuel Arenzay Ramirez Miranda, second year vascular surgery resident. Today I will talk about the clinical case performed at the Valentín Gómez Faria Regional Hospital, ISTE, about the right pathology, the pulmonary artery aneurysm. In our patient, 61 years old patient, has an important history of hypertension, dyslipidemia, and recent diagnosis of pulmonary hypertension. In this case, our patient assists the emergency service with dyspnea of median effort, which requires starting a diagnostic protocol. TOC, sputum smear negative for tuberculosis, negative serological test for syphilis, and negative clinical history for trauma. The principal acquired disease were discovered. We suspect that the possibility of inadequate control of the patient arterial hypertension that may have caused the aneurysm because of the late presentation of the symptoms according to the age of our patient without ruling out congenital cardiac pathology. It was decided to complement the diagnosis with imaging tests. During our patient hospitalization, the cardiology department decided to perform a transthoracic echocardiogram where severe pulmonary valve insufficiency was identified. A pulmonary valve with 40 millimeters in diameter and significant dilatation of the pulmonary trunk, like in this image we can see. This is the video of echocardiogram. We can see the turbulence detected when applying the color transthoracic Doppler and the level of the pulmonary wall with approximately 40 millimeters, like previously I comment. With a contrast tomography, the dilatation one confirmed at the level of the left pulmonary artery. In the image, we can see one of the captures of the aneurysm and its dimension beyond what is commonly reported in literature. The measure of the anatomic structure during the CAT CT scan show a maximum diameter of up to 12 centimeters in the vessel defect, like in this image I can see. The patient was kept hospitalized and scheduled for a hemodynamic study. To corroborate the dimensional pressure and the vessel level. An approach was performed at the level of the femoral vessel, tracing a pigtail catheter for the administration of contrast medium. The measured pressure was 28 millimeters of mercury, 3 millimeters of mercury above normal of pulmonary artery. In this image, we can see of the aneurysm after administration of contrast medium. Unfortunately, the measure were graded to achieve endovascular intervention. The image in the sides were considered the most important shot of the study, which showed the intraluminal pressure of the artery and the vessel wall defect, 12 centimeters, like I was said. In this slide, we see different images of the procedure and the captures where the measures are evident. The cause was discussed and it was decided to conduct a medical session for treatment planning and to include the cardiovascular surgery department. Due to the dimension of the aneurysm, did not allow a proper placement of any endovascular therapy. It was decided in the session that the patient did not qualify for endovascular treatment since the aneurysm was greater than 6 centimeters, like the literature and bibliography said. It was agreed in the surgical medical session the replacement of the pulmonary bed and pulmonary branch passed. Thanks for the time and attention of this presentation. On behalf of the team involved in this case, I'll send a greeting from Jalisco, Mexico. This is the Hospital Regional Valentín Gómez Farías.